Welcome to the first episode of Fantasy Night with John and Christie. I'm Christie. This is John.
And this is your Fantasy Night.
No, don't confuse us. Don't confuse it with porn. We're all about fantasy football here. Yeah. Right? Abernathy, yeah, fantasy football. So, let's talk a little bit about the draft party.
Why?
Because it was a lot of fun. I think that we, you know, like, I finally got some awards.
I'm glad it's over.
It was the paper kind, but...
I'm glad it's over.
Why? I wish it could just go on and on. Anyway, I hope everybody had fun. Had fun.
Insane.
You know me. I'm a people pleaser.
Well, this part of the show, what we'd like to do is give any news or information going out. One of the things we really want to try to make sure we take advantage of is the website and all of its features. Try to increase trades, trash talking, you know, a lot of interaction and communication. The website does it through email and message boards, and everyone has opportunity to post an article with embedded video like I've started doing. But hopefully the video will allow a lot more interaction in between and get a lot more information out. We'll also talk about any kind of news or information. For example, we've got the Thursday night game. You know, need to get any players that you have playing a Thursday night will be locked once the game starts. So set your lineup for those players definitely before the Thursday night game starts. Everyone else, you can wait until the Sunday noon games before game time then to go ahead and set your lineup. So that kind of information, talking about trades when they become, or trades are available right now, but ad drops are not available until after week two.
Oh.
See, no. She didn't know. Don't ask her, you get a better answer from the dog.
Hey, that's what I mean.
But anyway, that kind of stuff, information. Also, if you have any questions, post them on the website, send an email, ask me. We'll go ahead and answer it during this section too. So if you need help, you know, on your lineup, you know, we'll find an impartial and unbiased person to evaluate your choice there and give you an honest answer if you don't trust us. We have an unbiased professional available, so we can do that for you. Anything else that we need to talk about the news section or information or anything like that?
I don't think so.
And every week also, you know, as we go along, we're going to have a review of what the last week was and see how it affected the divisions and the, you know, standings and everything like that. But since we don't have a game yet, that's it. There's no standings or anything like that. All we have is our predictions, which we're getting into now.
Game's coming up. This week we're going to give our opinions on, or our predictions on who's going to win.
Yeah.
And who's going to lose.
The first game we're going to be taking a look at would be Twin Turret Mojo. I'll just tell you right now, here now, the undefeated season has started, and Twin Turret is going to rock it all the way. So, is that Twin Turret? Go ahead.
You're choosing Twin Terror.
Yeah.
Well, I was going to choose Twin Terror. I think I'm going to go with Mojo. Yeah, just because.
Okay.
So that when Mojo whoops you, I'm going to be like dancing all over the place.
Oh, and so what do I get whenever I beat him like a Indian drum?
It doesn't matter. You're going to give me hell for whatever I choose. So...
I'm just thinking Justin's going to go down like a head cheerleader. Forgive, you know, all of those head cheerleaders out there. Second game of the week we're going to take a look at is Freedom Riders at Shaps. Yeah.
And I'm taking the Shaps. Thomas Henley. He always comes in and he drafts pretty good and everything. He always does well, and I think against Freedom Riders, he's going to take a win.
Well, I'll have to agree with you on that. Shaps is going to pull a win out this week. I mean, there's some serious questions about the Freedom Rider right now that I've got to see them in action for at least a week or so and get a better idea of how that team's going to handle.
All right, the next game is Lopes, Chris Wilson versus the Reds. That would be me. Who are you taking, baby?
What do I get here? What do I get? I'm going to go with my wife on this one. I need to sleep. I like the rest.
It's based on the strength of my team, Chris.
Yeah, that's what it is.
I'm going with the Reds also.
Yeah, imagine.
I'm choosing myself. Like, what kind of confidence builder would it be? I wouldn't be very credible if I didn't go with myself.
Inspire your players. So. Go team. Rah, rah. Next game, we're looking at Intimidators at Allstutz Army.
Well, Allstutz got a really, really, really good team. I'm going with Allstutz Army.
And this one's not a, it's a no-brainer. Allstutz Army, easy. Intimidators has some serious, serious roster issues. No kicker. Two of their receivers are not playing for a while. One of them's out completely, and another one's out until he decides to sign, and then he's still got a suspension served. So, okay, you have receiver core is damaged. You got one of your running backs. Your back, granted, he's back up. He's hurt.
No. Here's the difference between I see the good. Allstutz Army is good. Did I say anything about the Intimidators? No. He has to bring you down, Martin.
I'm just covering both sides of the story here.
You got a couple weeks. Fix your team.
You ain't got a couple weeks. You're about to take a whooping.
Well, maybe this week.
Shed game. That's all I'm going to say right here.
Okay. On to the next one. Headbangers versus the Cowboys. Now, I think that this is going to be one of the games to watch.
It'll be a lot closer than the last one. That's for damn sure. Who are you going with?
I'm going to go with Headbangers.
I think that's a wise choice. I would have to go with the Headbangers as well.
All right.
I'm not going to say anything bad about the Cowboys. You got some issues. We're going to have to see how your plays for a couple of weeks and see how it goes. But anyway, okay, I couldn't resist. Sorry. Am I going to be the negative guy?
No. Here's one thing. You're all analytical and you get your computer and everything. Let me tell you, Lee told us beforehand that he started 2 months ago looking at players, getting online. All I'm saying is, a lot of teams, when he drafts, you sit there, or I look at them, and it's just like this puzzled look, and he pulls it off. And he doesn't do a lot of trading, and he doesn't do a lot of ad dropping and everything, but his teams are always solid.
Wait, of all people, you should know better than anyone, you can sneak a crappy team into the playoffs. Don't
did that
you?
Last year at the Lopes. Yes, I did.
So anyway,
well, all I'm saying is he can manage.
Now, doing it 4 years in a row, pretty damn impressive. But I didn't say he had bad teams all these years. I'm just saying right now, I have questions about his team. So I got to see him for a week or two. That's all I said.
I'm choosing the Headbangers over the Cowboys, but that does not, that is, I just looked at the teams. That is not slighting Lee in at all.
I wasn't slighting him. I just said, I have questions.
He knows stuff that the rest of us don't.
Yeah, whatever. I'm going to be the negative guy. Who are you taking on this next one? We got Raymond's Raiders at Cammy's Cowboys.
Yeah, that's a father and son, but Raymond and I'm just going to have to go with Cammy's Cowboys. Raymond.
This is one of those close games. I mean, I'm really having a hard time choosing one over the other. It's not like I want to avoid hurting anybody's feelings. God forbid hurting somebody's feelings. I want to get over it. I'll go ahead and be the other side. I'll go with Ravens Raiders.
You're going to go with Ravens Raiders?
Just because we need some kind of division, to be able to. I need to separate from her, I guess. I don't know.
You are
going to
paper, not the ex-husband.
Not yet. I can only hope. That's where my status, I'm trying to get my status to.
All right. We've made our predictions. Tune in next week and we'll resolve these and maybe we'll have some more content. We're begging you for content.
All right. See ya.
Perfect.